Hi, before this video, you should already understand the words and concepts found in financial statements. Now, when I say financial statements, I mean the balance sheet and the income statement. Alright, so welcome back again to MBAbullshit.com. The topic for this video is profit margin, which is one of the measures of profitability among financial ratios. Alright, so let's analyze this ratio now. Remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com. Alright, so this video discusses and analyzes the profit margin, which is one of my free videos on liquidity, profitability, and market value, which include these ratios over here. And after these, you can check out my next videos on MBAbullshit.com, such as my video on financial leverage ratios, which includes this, and my other videos on turnover ratios, which includes this. Alright, so let's get down to it. So let's start with a story. Let's say that ABC company has $1,000 in net income and $2,000 in sales. What is its profit margin? It's very simple. Okay, now, when it comes to financial ratios, the actual ratio is very simple. What's more important is what the ratio tells you. Okay, so the computation is simply 1,000 divided by 2,000. Where did we get this 1,000? It's the net income. Where did we get the 2,000? It is the sales. And we divide that by each other and we find that we have a profit margin of 0.5 or 50%, which is quite high, I think. Now, but actually you'll see later that high or low, it's relative, depending on what you compare it against, whether you compare it against a similar company or you compare it against your historical profit margin of your company or of this company. Alright, so what does a 50% profit margin mean? Well, simply it means that every time the company makes $100 in sales, it makes on the average a $50 profit. Okay, that's what it means. Therefore, a higher profit margin is usually considered better. Okay, however, there are some flaws in using this ratio. Okay, some companies can have a very low profit margin but still be very profitable. For example, Walmart. Why is Walmart so successful? Well, there are many reasons why Walmart is successful, but I guess the main reason is that it's very cheap. The stuff you can buy there is very cheap. And one of the reasons why it's very cheap is because Walmart has a low profit margin. I mean, okay? So they don't add much profit between the cost of the stuff they're selling and the actual sales, okay? Now, so Walmart has low profit margin but huge volume, and they end up with huge profit in the end. Okay, if Walmart were to try to increase its profit margin, their prices would go up and they would lose volume, and they probably would become not profitable. Okay, because people like going to Walmart because it's cheap. Okay, so that is one of the flaws of this. Now, the second flaw in using this ratio is that a high profit margin does not necessarily mean high cash flow. Remember, financial managers prefer cash flow over profit, or instead of profit. So, in some cases, well, not in the case of Walmart, because Walmart is a cash business, but in some cases, in some companies, a company might have a high profit margin because of accrued sales and not cash sales. Accrued sales means you made the sale, but then the customer hasn't paid you yet for the service in cash. So if you already made the sale and the customer has not yet paid you, that will still appear as a sale in your income statement. Okay? And Therefore, you might not be able to benefit yet from this profit because the cash part of the profit, or you might get paid in cash very far into the future. Okay. Now, there are also some traditional ways of analyzing financial ratios, and the first is to compare the historical, compare your most recent profit margin based on last year's profits, compare it with your historical profit margin. If your profit margin is higher now than last year's, then it might indicate better cost and expense management than before, and may also indicate, like I use the word indicate because it's not 100% sure, okay, it's just an indicator, and or a more profitable profitable company. If your profit margin is lower than last year's, then this might indicate lousier cost and expense management than earlier years, and or a less profitable company. The next thing you do in traditional analysis of financial ratios is to compare the profit margin to other similar companies. Okay, similar companies. Now I stress similar companies because it's useless to compare the profit margin of Walmart to, for example, a car company like Toyota. Obviously, a car company would have very high profit margins, but less, or a car company like, no, not Toyota, maybe a car company like Ferrari. Obviously, a car company like Ferrari would have a very high profit margin, but they have low volume. Okay, Walmart would have very low profit margins, but high volume. So if you want to look at the profit margin of Walmart, it's best to compare it to the profit margin of Target, for example. Okay? So, if your profit margin is higher than theirs, then this might indicate better cost and expense management than them, and it might indicate a more profitable company. If your profit margin is lower than theirs, then this might indicate lousier cost and expense management than them, and or a less profitable company. Alright, so there you have it. Remember to share it if you like it, and follow me on Twitter. Just look for MBA Bullshit, and go join my fan page on Facebook to get the latest updates on my latest videos. I usually post them first on Facebook, so go to facebook.com/MBAbullshit. And please forward my YouTube links on your email or on your other social media. So have a great day and goodbye.